हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम बालाजी राव। वेलकम टू बीआर मैक्स क्लास। दिस इज सेकेंड क्लास ऑन डोमेन ऑफ ए फंक्शन सीरीज। इन लास्ट क्लास वी लर्न व्हाट इज डोमेन ऑफ ए फंक्शन एंड वी डिड सिक्स इजी प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन हाउ टू कैलकुलेट डोमेन ऑफ ए फंक्शन। इन दिस क्लास वी विल डू अनदर सिक्स प्रॉब्लम्स। For what values of x the function is defined, that is known as domain of the function. You observe this question number 7, domain of square root of x square minus 25. How to calculate domain of this? In today's class, whatever the 6 problems I will do, in all 6 problems, this square root will be there. Here, what we learned in last class, whatever the expression is there in square root, this expression must be greater than or equal to 0. So here what I will write, x square minus 25 must be greater than or equal to 0. If x square minus 25 is less than 0, then this function is not defined. Okay, so what I need to find now? I need to find for what values of x this inequality holds good. That what I need to find. What I'll do first, I'll write this into linear factors. This 25 can be written as 5 square. See, x square minus 5 square is greater than or equal to 0. Now it is in the form of a square minus b square. A square minus b square formula is a plus b into a minus b. So x square minus 5 square can be written as x plus 5 into x minus 5. X plus 5 into x minus 5 greater than or equal to 0. Now what I need to find, for what values of x this inequality holds good? By using wavy curve method, we can easily say for what values of x this inequality holds good. What is that wavy curve method? As these are the linear factors, what I'll do, I'll equate this to 0. If I equate this to 0, you will get x equal to minus 5. Next, I'll equate this to 0, I'll get x equal to 5. Minus 5, plus 5. You mark them on the number line. Which one comes first? Minus 5 comes first. So minus 5, 5. After writing like this, in the rightmost corner, you write plus. As per wavy curve method, we will write like this. Blindly you write plus. Okay. Once in the rightmost corner, if you written plus, you write alternate symbols. Minus, after minus, alternate symbols, plus like this. In this interval, this expression is positive. In this interval, this expression is negative. In this interval, this expression is positive. What I want? I want greater than or equal to 0. Greater than or equal to 0 means positive or negative. Greater than or equal to 0 means we want positive sign. So where is the positive sign here? See, this is the zone. In this zone, this expression is positive. This is the zone. In this zone, this expression is positive. So what I'll write here, x belongs to minus infinity to minus 5. Here, you need to observe one thing. Here, greater than or equal to. Equality symbol is there, na? That's why I'll write closed brackets. For infinity, always open bracket. Because infinity is not defined. Okay. Minus infinity to minus 5. This interval, I written. Union. Union. From here to here. What is this? This is 5 to infinity. Closed interval. Why I am writing closed interval? Because here, equality is there. 5 to infinity. What I am trying to say, this expression is greater than or equal to 0 whenever x is in this interval. For example, you take one number in this interval. Suppose you take 6. 6 is there in this interval? Yes, 6 is there. 6 plus 5, positive or not? Okay. 6 minus 5, positive or not? Positive into positive, positive only, na? Right? You see here, you take any number here. What number I can take? Minus 6 I can take. Minus 6 plus 5. Minus 6 plus 5, negative. Minus 6 minus 5, negative. Negative into negative, positive only, na? So in that way, we can easily find in what interval this expression is positive. Suppose you take any number in this interval, this expression is clearly negative. If you want to check, just check like this. Suppose 0 is there in this interval. You put x is 0. 0 plus 5, positive. 0 minus 5, negative. Positive into negative, negative. So whatever you take, suppose I want to know in what interval this expression is negative, I'll take this interval. I hope you understand, right? What is the domain of the function? This is the domain of the function. When I take x value in this interval, this expression is there, x square minus 25, that will be greater than or equal to 0. Then this function is defined. So domain of this function is what? Minus infinity to minus 5 union 5 to infinity. I hope you understand this. You observe this question. 1 divided by square root of x square minus 25. I want to calculate domain of this function. To calculate domain of this function, you observe this is of the form f of x divided by g of x. When the given function in the form of f of x divided by g of x, denominator cannot be equal to 0. This part cannot be equal to 0. And you observe in this function, square root is also there. When square root is there, whatever the expression is in square root, it must be greater than or equal to 0. So what I'll write here, I'll write like this, x square minus 25, yes, this expression is in square root, I'll write like this, greater than or equal to 0. But equal to 0, x square minus 25 equal to 0, if I take x square minus 25 is 0, this denominator is becoming 0, then this function is not defined. So what I should consider here, I should consider x square minus 25 strictly greater than 0. I hope you are understanding. This function is defined only when x square minus 25 is greater than 0. Even though it is in square root, as it is in the denominator, we will take strictly greater than. Got the point? Now, what I need to find? For what values of x, this expression is greater than 0. For that, I am going to use wavy curve method. For that, I need linear factors. X square minus 25 can be written as x plus 5 into x minus 5. 25 can be written as 5 square, na? Right. Now, as I got the linear factors here, by using wavy curve method, I can say for what values of x this inequality is positive. You take the number line. You equate this to 0. You will get x equal to minus 5. Minus 5. Okay. You equate this to 0. You will get x equal to 5. After that, in the rightmost corner, you write plus. Rightmost corner, you write plus. And then alternate symbols. Minus, plus. What I want here, I want for what values of x this expression is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means positive only, na? I want for what x values this expression is positive. So in this area, in this interval, this expression is positive. In this interval, this expression is positive. In this interval, this expression is negative. Greater than 0 means I want positive sign. So what I'll write, x belongs to minus infinity to minus 5. Here, minus 5. For minus 5, closed interval or open interval. You see here, strictly greater than is there. When strictly greater than is there, you take open interval. Union. I want positive sign. Open interval. Again, open interval because strictly greater than. Open interval. 5 to infinity. If I take any x value in this interval, this function is defined. Suppose, if I take x value in this interval, this function is not defined. So, what is domain of a function? In last class also, we clearly specified what is domain of a function, for what values of x the function is defined, that is known as domain of the function. For what values of x the function is defined, that is known as domain of the function. So what is domain of this function? Domain of this function is minus infinity comma minus 5 union 5 comma infinity. I hope you understand this. You observe this question number 9. I want to find domain of this function. First thing, in this question, square root is there. What you know, whatever the expression is there in under root, it must be greater than or equal to 0. So what you need to know here, 25 minus x square is greater than or equal to 0. Now, this function is defined only when this expression is greater than or equal to 0. What you need to find, for what values of x, this inequality holds good. I can calculate this very easily with the help of wavy curve method. But to calculate with the help of wavy curve method, this expression must be in the form of x minus a into x minus b. I want this expression in the form of x minus a into x minus b. Then I can easily calculate the values of x with the help of wavy curve method. This complete inequality, I'll multiply with minus. This complete inequality, you multiply with minus, this minus will become plus. X square minus 25 is less than or equal to 0. When I multiply this complete inequality with minus, we know that in an inequality, if we multiply with a negative real number, inequality sign changes. Here greater than or equal to changes to less than or equal to. Now you see it is x square minus 25. 25 can be written as 5 square. So this is what? This is x plus 5 into x minus 5. Less than or equal to 0. Now I need to find out for what values of x this inequality holds good. Can I use Wavy-Curve method here? If it is in the form of x minus a into x minus b, then I can apply to this. Now on the number line, you equate this to 0, you will get minus 5. You equate this expression to 0, you will get minus 5. You equate this expression to 0, you will get plus 5. Now in the rightmost corner, plus alternate symbols, minus, plus. What is there here? Less than or equal to 0. Less than or equal to 0. That means less than 0 means I want negative sign. See here, in this interval, this expression is negative. So what I'll write here, x belongs to closed interval or open interval. Here equality is there. Na? Equality is there means closed interval. Closed interval minus 5 comma 5. I hope you are understanding. So what is the domain of this function? Domain of this function is closed interval minus 5 comma 5. You take any x value in this interval, this expression is positive. That means this function is defined. If you take any number other than this interval, this function is not defined. For example, 6 is not in this interval. You take 6 here. 6 square is 36. 25 minus 36. What happened? In the under root, you are getting negative number. Then this function is not defined. So what is domain of the function? For what values of x the function is defined, that is known as domain of the function. So what is the domain of this function? Closed interval minus 5 comma 5. Okay, question number 10. I want to find domain of this function. You can observe in this question, the square root is there. What you know, whatever the expression is there in square root, that must be greater than or equal to 0. So what I'll write here, x minus 2 divided by x plus 2. This expression must be greater than or equal to 0. And you observe this. This is of the form f of x by g of x. When the given function is in the form of f of x by g of x, then g of x cannot be equal to 0. This is in the form of f of x by g of x. Now this cannot be equal to 0. X plus 2 cannot be equal to 0. If x plus 2 is 0, this expression is not defined. I hope you are understanding. When this function is defined, whatever is there in under root, it must be greater than or equal to 0. Whatever is there in the denominator, it cannot be equal to 0. So you need to find the values of x which satisfies this condition. Here, what x value satisfies this condition? Here, I can use Wavy-Curve method. X minus a divided by x minus b form so that I can use Wavy-Curve method. As per the Wavy-Curve method, you equate this to 0. X minus 2 equal to 0 means x equal to 2. You mark it on the number line as per the number line order. You equate this to 0. X plus 2 equal to 0, then x is minus 2. Then you write like this as per number line order. Okay. Now, in the rightmost corner, plus. Next. Minus, alternate symbols, plus. Now I want to know for what x values this expression is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means positive sign you want. In this interval this expression is positive. In this interval this expression is positive. In this interval this expression is negative. I want greater than 0, that means positive sign. So what I'll write, x belongs to, what is there here, minus infinity to minus 2. Here closed interval or open interval. Here greater than or equal to is there. Na? So you may feel that you will write closed interval. But if I write closed interval, minus 2 is included. You see here x plus 2 not equal to 0 means x cannot be equal to minus 2. In this interval, minus 2 is included. So what I'll do here, I'll write open interval. If I write open interval, minus 2 is not included. Okay. Union 2 to infinity, 2 to infinity. So this is the interval. In this interval, this conditions holds good. So what is the domain of the function? Domain of this function is open interval minus infinity to minus 2, union 2 to infinity. I hope you understand this. You observe this question number 11. I want to find domain of this function. What thing you need to observe in this question? This is in this function, square root is there. So whatever the expression is there in under root, it must be greater than or equal to 0. So what I'll write, x minus 1 into x plus 1 into x plus 2. This must be greater than or equal to 0. Now what I need to find, for what values of x this inequality holds good? For this, I can use Wavy-Curve method. In that method, first what I'll do, I'll take a number line. Equate this to 0. What you will get? You will get 1. Okay. Equate this expression to 0. What you will get? You will get x equal to minus 1. Equate this expression to 0. You will get x equal to minus 1. That minus 1 I'll write here. You equate this expression to 0. X plus 2 equal to 0 means x is minus 2. So I marked the numbers as per the number line. Now in the rightmost corner, plus. Now alternate symbols, minus, plus, minus. What I want? Greater than 0. Greater than 0 means positive sign. In this interval, this expression is positive. In this interval, this expression is positive. As I want positive sign, where is the positive sign? That is the domain of this function. In this interval, see here, greater than or equal to is there, na? As equality is there, I'll take closed interval. Closed interval, minus 2 comma minus 1. Okay, union. Union 1 to infinity. I want positive sign, na? Closed interval or open interval. Here equality is there, na? 1 to infinity. For infinity, always open interval, open brackets, right? So what is the domain of this function? Closed interval, minus 2 comma minus 1, union 1 to infinity. You observe this question number 12. We want to find domain of this function. You can observe two things here. One is, it is in the form of f of x divided by g of x. Second one, in this function square root is there. We know that whatever the expression in square root, it must be greater than or equal to 0. So x square minus 6x plus 5 must be greater than or equal to 0. And one more thing, as it is in the form of f of x divided by g of x, this g of x cannot be equal to 0. This denominator cannot be equal to 0. If this denominator is 0, this function is not defined. But here I written greater than or equal to 0. That means I need to remove this equality here. So this function is defined only when this expression is greater than 0, because as it is in the denominator. Now what I'll do, I need to find for what values of x this inequality holds good. To apply wavy curve method, I want this in the form of x minus a, x minus b. So I'll split the middle term. This minus 6x I written as minus 5x minus x. Now in these two, I'll take x common. Take x common, what you will get? X minus 5. In these two, you take minus common, then you will get x minus 5, greater than 0. So x minus 5, if you take common, then you will get x minus 1 into x minus 5 is greater than 0. So I just splitted the middle term, I got like this. Now you see, it is in the form of x minus a into x minus b. By using wavy curve method, I can easily say for what values of x this interval is greater than 0. Okay. Now equate this to 0, what x value you will get? You will get x equal to 1. Now equate this to 0, what x value you will get? You will get x equal to 5. As per the wavy curve method, right corner, rightmost corner, you keep plus first. Later alternate symbols, minus, plus. Now what I want, for what x values this expression is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means positive. In this interval, this expression is positive. In this interval, this expression is positive. So what I'll write, x belongs to, minus infinity to 1. Open interval or closed interval? Here strictly greater than is there, na? That's why it is open interval. Union 5 to infinity. For 5 also open interval, because strictly greater than is there. So what is the domain of this function? Open interval minus infinity to 1, union open interval 5 to infinity. I hope you understand this class. Dear friends, it is all about practice. I am promising you again, I'll do at least 50 to 60 problems on the domain of a function. And we always do from easy to difficult level. Okay. If you like this video, please drop a like and share this video with your friends. In case if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, subscribe now. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.